Okay, so handoff strategies, it says that process of transferring an active call from one cell to another cell while you are on a move. So what does it mean? It's pretty simple to understand. It says that if there is one cell here, so this is my one cell and this is my N1 adjacent cell. So this is going to be, let me label it cell 1 and this is my cell 2. And this is your mobile station, so this is going to be your mobile, and you are on an active call. Okay, you are on active call, and you are also on a vehicle, or you are moving. Okay, so you are moving from one cell to another cell with some velocity. You are moving, and you move to another cell, and now your cell or the mobile is on the cell 2 location. So whenever you do that, you are on some base station here. You are on the control of some BTS. That is base transceiver system, and now you are in the control of another BTS of cell 2. So whenever this criteria has happened, you are changing or you are moving from one cell to another cell, your BTS or your base transceiver system is also, you know, changing from one cell to another cell. There is a disruption, or there is, you know, it is something like this. There is a disruption in this particular region. So you are moving from one location to another location here. There is this area which we particularly call there is no connection. And you had seen precisely in the roaming scenarios that you fail to get connected whenever you move from one city to another city. This is the exact thing, you know, handoff strategies is giving you. We will precisely see this handoff strategies in our GSM and GPRS sessions. But right now you just understand that it is process of transferring an active call from one cell to another cell as mobile unit, or your mobile moves from first cell to another cell, or without disconnecting your call, which is very important. Okay, your call is actually connected, but it will get disconnected whenever you come in that particular region, that roaming region. Okay, and also the amount of received power by mobile phone, or the amount of received power or by your BTS, both are usually need to determine whether a handoff is necessary or not. It means, as I told you in the previous session, that in the cellular system, that if you are very near to the BTS, then your mobile will not take much charge or much power, as you are very near to the BTS. Your signals from the BTS is going to be received to the mobile station easily. However, if you are very, very far from your BTS, then your mobile is going to take enough, you know, charge, because the signal is not receiving to the mobile station. It takes time, right? So that's why this mobile is going to take a large enough of charge. So it says that it completely depend on the power also, that the handoff strategy is needed or not. Okay, so this is your handoff strategies. I think this completes your channel assignment strategies. We had seen fixed, dynamic and handoff. I hope you like it. Thank you so much for listening to me. If you haven't subscribed my channel, I insist you to please subscribe it. Like, comment and share. Thank you.